Hey guys, today's my game of Ripper. This is kind of like I think it's an investigative, dystopian, futuristic adventure game that was released in 1996. Very cool. Ripper, I guess the name is based off of, like, Jack the Ripper, right? The serial killer. So this is, like, in the future. So, yeah, I think it's pretty interesting. I always loved these interesting adventure games from the 90s. They always have really cool premises and ideas. Let's take a look. Oh, what's this? Christopher Walken's in this. Mid-90s adventure game.
My editor, Ben Dodds,
Manhattan
called me at 3 a.m. to give me the news. It was a woman this time, the third victim. Of all the reporters in the city, the Ripper picked me to write to. I knew that another mad letter to the city was soon to come, and I would run it on the front page of the Virtual Herald. I would let the world know the Ripper had killed again.
Hey, how you doing? I hope you haven't eaten yet, Quinlan.
Figured you'd get here sooner or later, Quinlan. You can't get enough of this story, can you?
I think everyone's had enough of this story, Magnata.
Yeah, so that was a really cool intro, actually. Very cool intro with nice music. So yeah, Ripper, I guess, is alluding to Jack the Ripper. We have another serial killer now in the future. This is set in 2040. So it's kind of some kind of futuristic Jack the Ripper type of serial killer, I guess. Wow, this is full motion video. That's cool. So yeah, this is from a first person's perspective, looks like. Man, look at all this. Why are they still using these old school monitors, CRT monitors, in the future too? Oh man. Okay. Okay, what else can we do here? Oh, can I investigate stuff? What's this? This looks like my own like handheld PC or something like that. Oh. Power reset. What's this? Oh, okay, I see. This is how I set the volume. There we go. Brightness. Sure, add bitmap color, contrast, tint, master volume. Okay. Now we're done. So that's just the settings here. What's this? Murder scene. So this is where I am. This is to save, I guess. This power database notebook. This is my little laptop thing. Record my stuff. Save game, okay. That's where I save the game. Let's see. What's this options panel? Oh, it's Christopher Walken. Hey.
Don't go taking any souvenirs, Quinlan.
Same MO as the others?
You got it. Look around, you asshole. If anything, this is more gruesome than the other two. Hell of a lot more splatter.
Who's the victim?
Name's Stein. Renee Stein. Age 43. Book editor over at Knopf.
Any connection to the other two?
Well, let's see. Estevez was a programmer. Mendler, a dry cleaner. It'll take me 48 hours to run it down, but there's no connection here.
Guy kind of looks like Ryan Gosling. Like a discounted version of Ryan Gosling.
You have any clues?
No sign of forced entry. Nothing's disturbed. Two sets of prints. Hers and her mother's. The only thing not where it should be is this woman's insides.
Well, what about witnesses? I mean, this guy must have been a bloody mess, even if it's 3 o'clock in the morning, it's Greenwich Village. Somebody must have seen him.
As far as I know, he left us with one witness, and she's feeling a little fragmented at the moment. This guy is unfucking believable.
Why is her computer on, Magnata?
Well, it looks like she was in a public library node. Well, let me ask you a question. You got any mail lately? Maybe a little something from your pen pal?
He writes after the fact, not before. You should know that, Magnata. I wouldn't hold out on you.
Of course not. You've been very good about sharing what you know with me and several million other people. I should have busted you when you ran that first letter without letting us know about it. All right, visiting hours over. There's nothing here you haven't seen at the other murder sites except a few extra gallons of body fluids.
Well, you shouldn't be touching anything, should you, Magnata?
I guess this case has me rattled.
Okay. Quite the character.
Object scanned into database.
Yeah, he just threw that down, right? Nothing here?
Cold Carl Stasiak. We gotta stop meeting like this. Carl!
Sorry, Quinlan. What'd you say?
Is there any difference between this murder and the previous ones?
It was identical. Absolutely identical. It was a precision cut. A perfect line. And the way he empties out the body cavity. The way the organs are blown all around the room.
So it's the same killer?
Oh, for sure. I mean, the organs, they're completely cut to pieces. I've never seen anything like this in my life. It's amazing.
Want any clues to how it's done?
Don't ask me. You'd think I'd be used to seeing things like this by now. But I'm not. Whoever did this is beyond madness. It's pure evil.
Yep. Basically same as Jack the Ripper, right, who is known for, like, taking, the organs and mutilating them and stuff. Alright,
any progress in the investigation?
Who knows? Trying to get anything out of Magnata is next to impossible. Besides, if he does have a lead, he sure as hell never share it. He might lose his bounty if he does that.
Well, you've been working with Magnata for years, Carl. What's your hunch?
Well, something's bugging him. Who am I to talk? I'm having nightmares about this. I've been a forensic photographer for 22 years, and nothing's ever got to me like this. Now I can't sleep.
No, you just need a vacation, that's all.
Yeah, I hope you're right.
Any idea what weapon he's using?
Take a look at this mess.
Wouldn't one be a forensic photographer?
It has to be something big. A sword or a machete or something. Just can't cut through all that bone and muscle with the dagger. And the strength it would take to make a cut like that, he must be an enormous man. You know Vic Farley?
Yeah, the pathologist over at the Medicog.
He knows a lot more about murder weapons than I do. You should talk to him.
Incoming WAC transmission.
Quinlan here. Hey, Catherine.
Hey, Jake. How are things there?
Well, it's very... red.
What, anything different this time?
Just the name, Catherine.
Listen, Jake, something's come up here.
Something about the Ripper?
Might be nothing. I don't know. It could be something big. Just wait for me at the newsroom and I'll let you know as soon as I find out.
Now talk to me. What's going on?
I have to go. Trust me.
Who's in charge here?
Well, after last night, I'd say that I am.
So all of a sudden, you don't have to explain yourself to me?
Look, if you don't hear from me in an hour, just go to my apartment and wait for me there. You can hang out with my crystals.
Catherine!
Yeah, so I would not want to be a forensic photographer. That sounds like a job that would give people nightmares. Give me nightmares for sure. Seeing blood all the time. Guts and stuff. Let's see, there's nothing else here. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else. Time to go out. Newsroom.
What's going on, Ben? Did Catherine get a break in the Ripper story?
I don't know, Jake. I thought you were the lead reporter in the story.
Well, so did I. Do you know what she's up to?
She's your assistant. You tell me. She ran out of here like the place was on fire.
Did another letter from the Ripper come in?
No, you know he doesn't send them to anybody but you.
Then I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see. Catherine and I met on the job. Despite reminding myself that mixing love and work can get messy, it didn't take long for it to become more than a professional relationship. She was supposed to be my assistant, but she was beginning to act like it was her story. I only hope that whatever lead she had, she wasn't in over her head.
Incoming WAC transmission. Source unknown.
Whoa.
Dear boss. Have you seen my work this morning yet? Your stories make the cops seem so confident. None of you know how I do it. You never will. You shouldn't let your girlfriend do your work for you. She is close to me, and I'm not laughing. She's my next job. She gets it today. The story's all yours. Yours truly.
Oh man, he's going after the girl.
Catherine!
Quinlan! Where are you going? Quinlan! Quinlan!
Usually it takes an hour to cross that part of Manhattan. I did it in 20 minutes, propelled by kicking myself in the ass for letting Catherine go out alone. I was scared as hell when I got there, but everything looked okay in her apartment. Until Catherine showed up, that is. Catherine, what is going on here? Catherine, what is it? What is wrong? What happened? What? No, Catherine, no, Catherine, fuck. Catherine, please, Catherine, fuck! The good news was Catherine wasn't dead. The bad news was that she was in a coma deeper than anyone thought possible.
Damn.
The ever-helpful, Detective Magnata, had her brought to the Tribeca Center for Cyber Studies, also known as the Medicog. Meanwhile, I stopped off at the police station to see a few sources and try to retrieve Catherine's portable WAC. Hopefully, she'll have left me a message.
So he somehow put her in a coma without killing her. Okay. What happened there? What?
Hey, Quinlan.
Oh.
The Ripper strikes again. I guess we'll be seeing your work on the front page again. Another body and another byline.
You know, if you just catch this guy, Brandon, I could go back to writing the police blotter on page 12.
Sorry to hear about your partner. She was a nice girl. I liked her when she came around here.
She used to come down here?
Came down here all the time. She used to do your legwork.
Right. I can't do everything, can I? What about the library? That was the last place Stein was seen alive.
Standard operating procedures to copy all libraries. C-space files, that kind of stuff.
What? How can I get my hands on what they found?
Hell, Quinlan, it's a public library. We just copied the files. Everything's still there.
Okay. You know, Lou, I think it's time I bribe a photographer. Where's Stasiak?
He's in Wyoming.
Oh, come on, Brandon. He's the only guy I haven't really talked to. You never know what he might have picked up on.
Yeah, well, that's the problem. He picked up on too much. I'm not kidding, Richie. He went to Wyoming. The case was too much for him, and he took a leave of absence.
Stasiak. Cold Carl Stasiak.
Yeah. Get this. After the Stein murder, his wife calls and says Carl needed a little vacation. So that was it. He just got up, no goodbyes, no nothing. He didn't even give me a call.
Fuck.
Okay. Let's go on, over here. Nothing. What about in there? No, I guess I can't go in that one. Oh, here. Let's go here. Detective Vincent Magnotta.
Something on another murder case. Hamilton Marford, eh? Does this have something to do with the Ripper?
Object scanned into database.
Okay, got it. For the next one. But this one.
Object scanned into database.
He's not gonna be happy.
Looking for something, Quinlan?
No, I just need to ask a few questions.
Because if I find out you're going through my stuff, I'll be glad to give you 72 hours in the tombs for tampering with an investigation.
Sling your shit at someone else, Magnotta. It's not my fault you can't catch this guy.
No, let's see.
Who is Wofford? You were looking at my stuff. Did you think I was kidding about arresting you? Well, it's not like you were hiding it. And we already ran the story in the Herald, so it's not really news to me. He was a cyber architect, right? See, what interests me, though, Magnon, is that you have a month-old file lying on your desk. Does it have something to do with the Ripper?
You're lucky I'm in a good mood today, Conan, because you come this close to finding out what it's like to be a human shish kebab rotating in one of our fine penal institutions. But you're way off on that.
What What's with this place you sent Catherine to?
Well, it's the best of its kind for flatliners. And it's got a doctor named Burton who practically invented the field. She's a real ball breaker, though.
What do you got on the Powell case?
Look, just because you two play tiddlywinks in your birthday suits doesn't mean I'm going to open police files for you. For all I know, you're a suspect. I mean, you were the only one there.
Okay.
Any new developments?
Yeah, the pile of bodies is getting bigger. I got crazies coming out the woodwork to confess. This Ripper's been spotted more times than Elvis. The mayor's on my ass. She wants to revoke my jurisdiction. I don't break this soon, every cop in Manhattan be looking to get a piece of my bounty.
And you accuse me of getting rich off the Ripper.
I'm usually real cooperative with the press, you know that. But watch yourself on this one, Quinlan.
Okay. Oh, I can't investigate anymore, huh? No, I guess not. Okay, guess I'll have to leave. What's over here? Guess I can't go there. Nope. Okay, let's get out. Catherine Powell's apartment. Let's go there. Investigate her apartment. Solar system? No, I see the constellations of the zodiac. Okay.
Catherine's crystals. I always thought they were a little too neo-new agey for Catherine.
What do these crystals do? I think you gotta put them in some certain order. Okay, what happens if you put them all? I don't know. I guess you're supposed to put them in a certain order. To find that out later. Happy birthday. I'm glad I found you. 225.90? That's way farther in the past. This game is apparently set in 2040, right? So at 90, that would be like 50 years ago.
Laser King. Wonder what this inscription means. J. Dorset.
Okay. What's this about? Is that some game? Some interesting stuff here. Nope. Some alien something. Oops. Yeah, there's nothing I can do here. Oops. Yeah, the thing about FMV games, sometimes it can be really clunky just to get to where you want to go. You gotta roll the animation every time. Okay, police station, I went to newsroom, Tribeca Center. Let's go here. Whoa. Is there anything I can do here? Oh, let's talk to the receptionist.
Medicog! Uh-huh, hold on. Medicog, uh-huh, hold on. Medicog, hold on. May I help you off with something?
Beg your pardon?
I said, can I help you? What'd you think I said?
Nothing. I'm looking for whoever's taking care of my girlfriend, Catherine Powell.
That would be Dr. Burton. Take the elevator to the second floor and make a right. If she's not there, go to ICU down the hall from there. Whatever you do, don't stand too close to her.
Why is that?
A little chilly.
Right. What can you tell me about this Dr. Burton?
She's the boss. I can't tell you anything. Not here anyway.
Where's Farley?
In the basement. Take the elevator, follow the smoke.
Smoke?
Yeah. As you know, Farley's not the cleanest pathologist going. But we haven't had any complaints from his patients yet. I need a soft touch for a smoke. If it wasn't for him, we'd never have any fun around here.
Let's see. Forest Lobby Morgue.
What are you doing here?
My name's Jake Quinlan. I'm a friend of Catherine's.
Quinlan?
How is Catherine? Is she going to be all right?
It doesn't look good. Her consciousness is deeply withdrawn.
Withdrawn? What's that mean?
It means her mental processes, her memory, the basic building blocks of her personality are inaccessible.
You mean she's in there, but you can't reach her?
That's a best-case scenario. We haven't yet diagnosed her psychic damage.
Well, is she going to be all right?
It doesn't look good. She's still in triage. We're going to just have to wait and see.
What are you doing for her?
I'm not doing anything for her as long as I'm standing here talking to you. Why don't you let me get back to work?
How did the Ripper do this?
It's hard to tell. She had some minor contusions on her head. Nothing fatal, but you never know with head injuries. We won't know anything until we can get a data angel in there to do some investigating.
You can get a data angel into the consciousness of someone in a coma?
I'm not sending anyone in there until I've had a chance to fully map her psychic damage. Now, if you don't mind.
I mind. How did Catherine survive the attack?
Who knows? Maybe she fought him off. More likely, someone or something interrupted the Ripper before he could finish.
You here to check on Miss Powell?
Yeah. She looks pretty bad. Is there anything you can do for her?
She's in good hands. And she'll be in even better hands once Dr. Burton allows us to treat her.
I'm guessing I can't go in. Oh, I can. Okay. Cool. There's nothing I can do here. I can only look at her, that's it.
Looks like a holographic journal. Could be worth looking at.
Our options are pretty limited here. I tried direct cortex stimulation. It's risky, but there's a chance of it working.
It's too risky. We could lose her that way.
Well, we could try inserting data angels for a diagnostic. There's no risk in that.
I disagree. We've no idea what's left of her natural defenses. The trauma could have made them even harder to penetrate.
All right, look, then let's run the Norton Mapper program so we can take a Stoll profile and a cortical landscape. Then we know what we're dealing with.
You mean that hasn't been done yet? Why not?
Because I said so. I want her to stabilize before we introduce any kind of foreign code. Thanks for the consultation, but that's my decision.
How much more stable does she want, the woman? She's in a coma.
What's her problem? She won't do anything. Are we supposed to just watch this patient die?
She's in charge. There's not much we can do.
Looks like that she's not doing very much. Games and their clunky navigation sometimes. Oh my God.
How am I supposed to open this?
I'm gotta get back to the elevator. The store, yeah. Yeah, I missed it before. Okay. Warriors lobby. What's part of the morgue? Seems there. This is where they're doing autopsies.
Hey, Vic. What's for lunch?
Hey, Quinlan.
You working you hard?
Working me like crazy these days.
Hey, is this Renee Stein?
Are you kidding? You were at the crime scene. You saw her inside splattered everywhere.
Yeah, I guess I did.
Yeah. Was married to her, Ripper. This businessman away on a trip for 3 weeks. He gets paranoid that his partner's putting it to her while he's gone, so he flies home early and shoots her to death. I mean, stuff like that. That's why I never got married, you know? Had my chances, though. You know?
Any luck figuring out the Ripper's weapon yet?
I'm completely stumped. I did every test on these sticks. I mean, a computer cross-matched the wounds with every kind of blade imaginable. Nothing. I mean, it's like a cross between a Vegematic and a diamond cutter.
Come on, Vic. Something must have cut these people open.
Nothing these computers can find. Now, you don't believe me? Look at those control panels by the sticks.
You hear about my partner?
Who's that?
Catherine Powell. She was attacked by the Ripper. Somehow she got away. She's upstairs in a coma. Dr. Burton's treating her.
Oh, your friend's a good hand. Burton's a good doctor. And if she gets stuck, she'll probably call in her a secret weapon.
What's that?
A guy named Joey Falconetti.
Joey Falconetti. Who's Joey Falconetti?
Cyberspace expert that Burton uses on all the tough cases. Also known by his old C-Space handle, Falconetti. Get it? Crazy guy. Likes looking at the bodies. I'm surprised she hasn't called him in yet to look at your friend.
What do you mean?
Well, he's the best there is on human-to-human decking. She usually calls him in on that kind of stuff, but not on the Ripper work.
Where can I find this Falconetti?
Difficult guy to find. Burton usually goes to a guy named Gamut Nelson. He passes the time at the Café Duchamp.
Duchamp?
Duchamp. Well, you can find him there.
I see. Guess I'll have to find that guy. Oh man, what's going on here?
I tapped the nerve memory of this victim and fed it into the simulator so that I could reenact the attack. $1 million piece of hardware. And look what it gives me.
Jesus. Looks like she swallowed a fucking grenade.
Okay. Café Duchette, I think is where I want to go. It's a disc 2. Okay.
Is that a Quentin model whack you've got there? Let me see. I've been grepping for one of these for months. These are tough to find if you're not in the professions. What are you, a lawyer?
Reporter for the Herald.
Low end of the pay scale, eh?
Tell me about it.
You should work for yourself. There are thousands of ways to make money in the net. Believe me, I know.
Do you know Joey Falconetti?
Joey Falconetti. I haven't done business with that scoundrel in years. Talk about profiteering in the net.
But do you know him?
Eddie and I owned part of an emoticon franchise. You know, one of those sea-based emotional counter zones? This was
emoticons.
Years ago. Legitimate business.
1996. This is way before emoticons were invented.
Eddie's a thief by nature. Robbed it blind. We had to sell out to some Palestinians in New Dallas. I haven't worked with Eddie since, but I keep an eye on him so he doesn't pilfer any of my holdings.
Do you know where I can find Falcon Eddie?
You don't. The Falcon usually finds you and takes your money.
Well, lucky for me, I'm broke. A gravedigger named Farley at the Medicog told me that you might be a link to find him.
What's your interest? You out to kill him?
Well, it's not killing I had in mind.
Well, somebody's gonna whack that bird one of these days. Eddie's consciousness is inside a few hundred terabytes of well space with his body safely hidden. I set Medicog up with a guy named Twig. Lives out in Hoboken. He seems to always know where Eddie's at. Eddie usually presents himself with video. He likes to show off.
Hoboken. Mr. Nelson, what's your background with cyberspace?
Got some time. That would take a while. I've been decking with the global net since it went online. Present at the creation. That's why thugs like Falconetti disappoint me. Damn waste of talent.
Cool. So ask the bartender for a drink.
You can read your copy, Quinlan. You might nail this freak before the police do.
Just asking questions, seeing where the answers take me. Kind of slow in here.
Yeah, the Ripper's really put a damper on anonymous sex these days.
How about a beer?
Yeah, sure thing.
Why don't you try this one? It's called Viper Pills. Goes down real smooth. It's got some bite. On the house. Just nail the Ripper so that my customers can get drunk in public again, huh?
Okay. Cheers. What do you know about Gambit Nelson?
Gambit's been coming in here for years. The man has seen it all. He can remember when the net went online. Back when there weren't any wells, cyberspace was nothing but a bunch of isolated BBSs.
Must be a first-generation decker.
He's one of the first C-space entrepreneurs. He made a killing on that. All of it's legal. It's weird, huh? You know, a good guy wins for once in a blue fucking moon.
Center. Yep. Walford Cottage. What's this one?
Who goes there? Murderer! Murderer!
Of the English language, maybe. I'm just a journalist.
Beware you. I've got weapons here that can render you helpless.
Relax, old timer. I'm not here to hurt anybody. I'm just after some information.
You, sir, stand in my domain, and the question is, who are you? Speak quickly.
Jake Quinlan from the Virtual Herald.
Quinlan, I know that name. You're the one who speaks for the Ripper.
No, I don't speak for him. He just writes me letters and we print them. They're news. But who are you? I thought the owner of this house was dead.
One of them is my twin brother, Hammond. And he finished what he called the most fascinating project of his life. And then I found him shot dead right here in this room. And I thought he'd just fallen asleep.
What did the police tell you?
The police, bah! I'm sure they're in on it.
Do you think the police are in on your brother's murder?
It's obvious the way they were rooting around in Hamilton's work. Kept asking him for his well address. And threatened to lock me up if I didn't tell him. But they got nothing out of me. They took away cartons of his discs. But they won't find anything there. Hamilton was too smart for them to.
Was the cop a guy named Magnotta?
Yeah. I should have vaporized him. You'll get nothing out of me.
I'm sure. Why don't you tell me about your brother's work?
You don't know? He was famous. Or he should have been. He built virtual worlds, places from history and locations from the future, and you walk through them in cyberspace like walking through the corridors of time itself.
So basically, like VR.
He was a genius, like Leonardo.
And what was he working on in the end?
As I told you, mum's the word, as he would say. And all I know, it was something involving stranger research than usual. And he came out of cyberspace one night and he told me he'd spent the day in an English music hall. And that's all I can remember.
Wow. Who was your brother working for?
What makes you so sure that I know?
We all confide in someone. A brother's a good place to start.
I don't know. Hamilton.
Hey, you all right?
He's dead.
I know, it's hard. But you must have some way to at least find out who he was working for.
My brother thought that he was protecting me, I suppose. Yeah. Of course, how's the killer supposed to know he didn't tell me everything? Besides, I'm trustworthy as the day is long. It's not like I'm going to tell anyone about his secret hiding places.
Excuse me, what are you talking about? What about hiding places?
You know about the hiding places, huh? Huh? Well then, you know more than I do. Hamilton was like Leonardo, I tell you. With devices and concealments, components hidden in secret compartments all over the blasted house. If I could just find them, I could plug them in and get his, well, address. But I don't know where the hell half of them are anymore. Maybe I should just clean the whole place out and move.
But in other words, I have to locate and unlock secret compartments in this cottage to find the address to Hamilton's cyberspace well?
Well, yeah, that's the idea. Doubt you're clever enough to do it, though. Doubt you can do it.
Okay. Guy's a little bit senile, but... anyways, he gave me some information at least. What's this?
Virtual Dynamics Operating System.
Is this VR? It's like VR or something.
Exit cyberspace.
What? I mean, like a VR type of realm? That's interesting. Whoa. It's like a game inside of a game. That's really cool. Game inside of a game here.
Virtual library.
Whoa. I could use some help here. You're a human presence, I assume.
Everyone at a service desk is. The library doesn't use smart sprites for public interface. You don't read much, do you?
A note with some call numbers on it. Could Renee Stein have left this here? Did you see a woman named Renee Stein recently?
Records place her here, but she didn't check anything out, and I don't remember seeing her.
Have the cops talked to you?
They asked questions, but I couldn't tell them much. They copied all the files from the Victorian Root Directory and ordered us not to alter the file structures until the case is solved.
So any clues left from the day Stein was killed would still be here?
Guess so. I sure didn't take them.
Can you help me with this call number?
I'm sorry. This is not a valid call number. It appears Stein altered the reference matrix, but an unknown book was distributed. If you could unscramble the call number, I could help you.
What is this? Gettysburg, the Battle of Human Brain, 2000 million year, market crash of 96. I have no idea what this is.
You should really look into this, Quinlan. It could mean something.
Call number, what is this? Okay, I don't know what that is.
Virtual Herald.
Virtual Herald, okay. What's this?
Library.
Okay, let's hurry this up. I have to do this every time.
Exit cyberspace.
Let's see. That's cool. That's like a VR game inside of this game. That's interesting. To control the ball thing, okay? It's a cool little game. It's like that Marble Madness stuff. Oh, interesting. Okay. Cool.
I see these old guys don't get around to fixing things. Another antique. The Woffords have quite a collection.
What can I do there? Nothing, huh? Anyways, guys, I'll stop here, but this is Ripper, and I find this game actually pretty intriguing. It's a murder mystery stuff, you know, a serial killer going around, you're trying to investigate it. A lot of full motion video here. But yeah, if you're interested in this kind of mid-90s full motion video murder mystery stuff, I think you might be interested in Ripper. And it's also like a bit of sci-fi here as well, since it's in the future and stuff. So that's it, guys. Ripper, actually a pretty interesting game. Thanks for watching.